Hi, my name is Luis Garza. I'm a dermatologist at Johns Hopkins School of Medicine, and I study regenerative medicine. So what is regenerative medicine? Well, let's go to the toy box. It turns out that we have a set of instructions in every single cell of our body. And those instructions were executed when we were in the womb of our mother to build every single organ in our body. And because those instructions are maintained in all the cells that we have as adults, there's the exciting possibility of reactivating those instructions so that we can rebuild organs in adults. And that's the promise of regenerative medicine, and that's why we're so excited about it. So today we're gonna use some toys. This is the all-terrain defense pod, and we also have the Imperial shuttle. And these are magnificent, beautiful creations from the Star Wars universe that are really kind of a good demonstration of what a complicated machine can be. And they're not that different from the human body. After the birth, our organs are intact and function well, but during life, insults happen and our organs suffer damage. And there's chaos happens again. And so the question is, can regenerative medicine allow for us to kind of build order out of this chaos and capitalize on the properties of stem cells to self-assemble? All of our organs are intricate machines as well, and damage can hurt them. So for example, a big one in my field in skin is burns. So let's say, the all-terrain defense pod can suffer some burns, and that's gonna disassemble some of these very intricate parts and separate them into their subunits. Another example might be, for example, in the liver. So liver damage can occur, for example, from viruses like hepatitis, or in the heart, you can have a heart attack. And during a heart attack, you lose important muscle. And so all of these examples of damage result in disassembly. So you have, in a lot of cases, the cells are still there, but they're not connected the way they used to be. And that's exactly what's kind of happening here with this Lego, is the Lego had very intricate ordered parts, but through damage, in this case, my hands, the Lego's becoming disordered. And so the question is, can regenerative medicine provide a solution for healing here? Can the stem cells exhibit their normal properties of self-assembly in service of recreating organs that have been lost? The idea is that your body is pretty good at covering the plugging the hole after an injury. So after a burn, your body can seal the skin, but it doesn't do a great job at recreating all the structures that were there previously. And that's the definition of a scar. And what my lab is interested in is looking at these concepts in the skin. So normally the skin is, just like every other organ, is a highly structured system that has multiple component parts that act together to create something that's very valuable for all of us. So for example, here you can see that there are these regular layers in the skin, for example, that represent the intact organ. And not only are there important layers of the skin, there's also a lot of important structures in the skin. For example, like our sweat glands that help us maintain our body temperature when we're working out. Or also, for example, hair follicles that help us sense our outside world. The cool thing about these structures like hair follicles and sweat glands is they end up being kind of the nexus for multiple other organs. Like nerves, for example, come and are attracted to areas of hair follicles. Stem cells, like, for example, melanocyte stem cells that provide our pigment in our skin. The skin is a very highly ordered, structured unit that provides a lot of important function for us. But our lab is interested in asking, after injury, what happens? So let's say, for example, after a burn, a lot of this order is now changed into chaos and disorder. And so you lose your structures like hair follicles and sweat glands. The order of the different layers of skin now become completely separated. Now there's disorder and there's chaos. And the exciting process is to ask, well, how can we promote order again in the systems? RNA is normally a single strand, but we discovered that an important type of RNA when they're together, called double-strand RNA, can actually induce reordering after injury. So after a large-scale injury, that double-stranded RNA helps the layers become ordered again, such that now you have this regular repeating array of the intricate parts, and it also induced regeneration of structures like hair follicles. And we know, the hair follicles again are gonna be this nexus that attracts blood vessels and nerves and stem cells, such that at the end, in the presence of double-stranded RNA, we have enhanced regeneration. We're really excited about using double-stranded RNA to promote regeneration and prevent scarring in skin. We want to try to not only prevent scars, but treat them. And we're hoping that our discoveries can be a springboard in multiple organs so we can induce regeneration and create order out of chaos after injury. So magically, the machine is self-assembled and we've created order out of chaos. And that's the amazing power of stem cells in regenerative medicine.